Praise the Lord and greetings to you on this Wednesday, November the 22nd, 2023. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. God bless you on this day before Thanksgiving. Welcome to this service of prayer and meditation, where today we will also celebrate the Thanksgiving holiday. Welcome to St. John African Methodist Episcopal Church in Cleveland, Ohio. I am Henry Curtis, pastor of St. John, and it is a joy to be with you once again on this glorious day. Let us begin our time together with the words of the psalmist in Psalm 105 and 1, who said, "O give thanks unto the Lord and call upon his name. Tell the people what things he hath done." As we begin our time together, let us do so in prayer. Shall we pray? Almighty God, Father of all mercies, we, your unworthy servants, give you humble thanks for all your goodness and loving kindness to us and to whom you have made. We bless you for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life, but above all, for your immeasurable love in the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ, for the means of grace and for the hope of glory. And we pray, give us such an awareness of your mercies that with truly thankful hearts, we may show forth your praise, not only with our lips, but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to your service, and by walking before you in holiness and righteousness all our days, through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honor and glory throughout all ages. Amen. Our scripture lesson today comes from Psalm 18, verses 1 through 6. Hear the word of the Lord. I love thee, O Lord, my strength. The Lord is my rock and my fortress and my deliverer, my God, my rock, in whom I take refuge, my shield and the horn of my salvation, my stronghold. I call upon the Lord, who is worthy to be praised, and I am saved from my enemies. The cords of death encompass me. The torrents of perdition assailed me. The cords of Sheol entangled me. The snares of death confronted me. In my distress, I called upon the Lord. To my God, I cried for help. From his temple, he heard my voice, and my cry to him reached his ears. The word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. Our key verse today is Psalm 18 and 1. I love thee, O Lord, my strength. Let us pray. Lord, speak to me that I may speak in living echoes of thy tone. As thou hast sought, so let me seek thine erring children lost and lone. Now may the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. In Christ's holy name we pray, amen. Upon graduating from seminary, the bishop appointed me to serve as pastor of my first church. As a young pastor, I was excited to begin what had been a long-time dream of finally leading a congregation. I was blessed to be assigned to a good church, one with loving people, people who were accustomed to quote-unquote breaking in recent seminary graduates as their pastor. As I arrived in preparation to take the appointment, I met with my predecessor. He was an older pastor who was leaving due to retirement. He was a spirit-filled man whose love for the Lord was obvious to everyone he met. And one of his trademarks was leading the congregation in the following call and response. He would say, "Praise the Lord," and the congregation would respond, "He's worthy to be praised." These are simple, easy to understand words, yet they carry deep theological truth that we indeed serve a God who is worthy to be praised. The book of Psalms is the hymnal for ancient Israel, and many of the Psalms, or better translated into English, songs, are actually hymns of praise to God for what he did for Israel. Our reading today, taken from Psalm 18, has the following superscription above it, meaning these are the words that appear before the actual text of the psalm. And when you open the Bible and read Psalm 18, you will see the following superscription. It says, "Royal thanksgiving for victory. To the choir master, a psalm of David, the servant of the Lord, who addressed the words of this song to the Lord on the day when the Lord delivered him from the hand of all his enemies and from the hand of Saul." That is the context in which Psalm 18 is written. David is identified as the psalmist. David, we must admit, was a man who had a checkered past. He exhibited both admirable and reprehensible qualities. But through it all, the Bible says David was a man after God's own heart. So having been delivered from the hands of his enemies, and having been delivered from the wrath and the hand of Saul, filled with a heart of praise and thanksgiving, David wrote these following words. He says, "I love thee, O Lord, my strength." David was well aware of his many weaknesses. He knew that his strength alone was not sufficient to defeat his enemies. But God was with David. God was with David each and every day of his life. God was with David when David, as a young shepherd boy, took down the Philistine giant Goliath with a slingshot and rocks. David was not abandoned by God, though he was evil in God's sight by taking Bathsheba for himself and sending her husband to the front line of battle to die. God did not allow Saul, who wanted David dead in the worst way, to prevail against his servant. David, for all of his ups and downs, for all of his faults, and for all of the things that he did right in life, when it's all said and done, David had a heart of praise and thanksgiving. Why is that? I'm glad you asked the question. He had a heart of praise and thanksgiving because he knew what he deserved. And yet, God, who is merciful, God, who is gracious, God, who is loving, did not give David what he deserved. Rather, he blessed him in spite of his faults, shortcomings, and failures. In verse 6 of Psalm 18, a reflective and thankful David wrote these words, "In my distress, I called upon the Lord. To my God, I cried for help. From his temple, he heard my voice, and my cry to him reached his ears." I have good news for you today on this November the 22nd, the day before Thanksgiving. I have good news for you. Like David, our cries also reach God's ears. And when they reach God's ears, God hears us and he acts on our behalf. We serve a God who hears us and who acts for us. And God, when he acts, he does not act against us, but notice I just said he acts for us. Rather, because of God's love and his grace, he acts mercifully and graciously toward us, delivering us from the hand of our enemies. Today is November the 22nd, and November the 22nd is an infamous day in United States and, dare I say, world history. 60 years ago today, the 35th President of the United States, John F. Kennedy, was assassinated in Dallas, Texas. On a fateful Friday afternoon, a 46-year-old man's life ended in full view of the crowd gathered in Dealey Plaza and was captured on video that decades later is still hard to watch. The president was killed just 6 days before Thanksgiving that year, 1963. No doubt, a nation in mourning, it was hard for even the most faithful to muster up the energy or the will to give thanks. But hallelujah, they did. Several of you watching this video right now were among the millions of saddened Americans who, in the face of a great tragedy, still found strength and faith to give thanks to God. And now, some 60 years later, we are not yet a perfect nation. Like David, we have a collective checkered past as it relates to our actions not squaring up with God's commands and God's standards. But through it all, through our ups and through our downs, through our high moments and through our low moments, whether we're on the mountain or in the valley, we can still, like David, declare on this Thanksgiving Eve, "I love thee, O Lord, my strength." When the President of the United States was gunned down, God's strength kicked in to guide and to soothe the nation. When we fall into sin, God's strength kicks in to place us on the road to repentance and redemption. When the enemy rises up and seeks to assail us, God's strength covers us and protects us from all hurt, harm, and danger. As we give thanks to God for his goodness in our lives, let us do so with the understanding that God is indeed worthy of our thanks and our praise. So when gathering with family and friends this Thanksgiving, remember the times when God showed grace and mercy to you. Recall this Thanksgiving, how God protected you and delivered you from the hand of the enemy. And in so doing, remember that God loves you and never forget why you love God. David remembered these things when he wrote, "I love thee, O Lord, my strength." Here at St. John, we occasionally sing a song that I believe sums up all that we talked about today and puts a nice bow on this package called Thanksgiving. Words that clearly state our love for God and our petition that our praise will indeed rest on his ears. I love the song that says, "I love you, Lord, and I lift my voice to worship you, O my soul, rejoice. Take joy, my King, in what you hear. Let it be a sweet, sweet sound in your ear. Thanks be to God. Amen." Please join me in praying the prayer that Jesus taught his disciples. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, now and forever. Amen. Please join me in this special Thanksgiving prayer. Let us pray. Almighty and gracious Father, we give thee thanks for the fruits of the earth in their season and for the labors of those who harvest them. Make us, we beseech thee, faithful stewards of thy great bounty, for the provision of our necessities and the relief of all who are in need, to the glory of thy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with thee and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Receive God's blessing. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. This and all things we ask in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please accept this invitation for you to join us in worship here in our sanctuary at St. John African Methodist Episcopal Church, located at 2261 East 40th Street, Cleveland, Ohio, 44103. If you're unable to worship with us here in our sanctuary, you're invited to log on and join us virtually on our Facebook channel and later on this YouTube channel. If this video has been a blessing to you, please help the channel out by subscribing to the channel, by clicking the notification button so that you may be alerted when we post new videos, and by sharing the link with others so that they too will be blessed by God's word. It was truly a joy to be with you today. On behalf of my family, I wish you a very happy, healthy, and safe Thanksgiving. Have a great holiday, a great rest of the week, and we look forward to seeing you real soon. Until then, be blessed. Goodbye.